Namaste everyone, welcome to day 19 of our meditation challenge. We only have two more days to go, so if you've made it already until here, don't give up. We have very, very little left, and I tell you that you're going to feel a very, very big sense of achievement. So, yesterday we talked about the quality of giving and receiving and the importance of keeping that energy flowing. So when you receive something, make sure that you give an equal amount, so you open up space for receiving more, and so on and so on. So today we're going to talk about the quality of being aware and how important it is to be absolutely 100% aware of what's happening inside of you, but also around you. Why I believe that being aware is very important is because you never know whose life you can actually change for good in a daily situation. Imagine that your life is being recorded. I don't know if you know Big Brother or this type of reality shows, but their lives are being recorded all the time with the camera. So imagine that as you're walking about your daily life and your interactions with people, this is all being recorded somewhere out there. So would you just say anything that comes to your mind? No, right? You would be a bit more careful about what you do and the things that you, the way you act. So I think that being aware is a little bit like that. It's you don't have to be stressed out about how it looks like, but just keep it in mind that your actions, your words, they can have a reaction on somebody else. And this reaction can be positive, but can also be negative. So make sure that more and more of your actions have a positive reaction so that you can actually help other people in their spiritual way as well as they can help you. A very meaningful conversation or a very meaningful encounter with a person can switch a lot in your perspective. And also, being aware, which is what our meditation teaches us, really teaches us to be more mindful about our daily life and to be more receptive about your inner voice, because the inner voice always knows the right way to go. It's not out there. Nobody else knows what's right. You always know best, only if you listen to that inner voice. So this was also something during my yoga teacher training. We were talking a lot about the inner teacher, the inner guru. A lot of people search for the teacher outside of them, and this is not a bad thing for sure. You always need somebody to show you the way, but once you're on the right way, you have to turn in and you have to listen to your inner voice, because your intuition will tell you what's next. So I hope that makes sense for you. And we're going to try a breathing technique that teaches you to be a bit more aware of your breathing, and through the breathing be a bit more aware about other stuff as well. So let's take a nice position, rolling the shoulders back. Lengthen your spine, nice and long and proud. I just noticed I was crouching. So just lengthen your spine, bring your chin slightly in so you make a nice long neck. Then close your eyes, taking a deep breath in through your nose. Open your mouth and just say, one more time, inhale through your nose. Inhale, inhale, inhale. Exhale, last one, inhale, 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 and exhale completely. We're going to continue breathing only through the nose. You can press your tip of the tongue towards the upper palate of your mouth. Just try to see how that feels, nice and light. So one of the branches of yoga, Ashtanga yoga, is called Dharana, concentration. And this is the first step before our meditation practice, to concentrate on one single thing at a time. So we're going to try the 7 points concentration. The first point is noticing the moment you start inhalation. The second point is noticing the process of the inhalation. The third point is noticing the end of the inhalation. The fourth point is to notice the beginning of your exhalation. The fifth point is to notice the process of your exhalation. The sixth point is to notice the end of the exhalation. And the seventh point is to notice that space of nothing, in between, state between inhale and exhale, between exhale and inhale. This really precious golden moment in which a lot of things can happen. Feels like time has stopped. Alright, so let's try this together. First, take a deep breath in. Exhale completely. And now start to notice the beginning of your inhalation. One. Notice the process of your inhalation. Two. Notice the end of your inhalation. Three. Notice the beginning of your exhalation. Four. Notice the process of your exhalation. Five. Notice the end of your exhalation. Six. Seven. Notice the space of nothing. You can continue a few times on your own. 7 points of attention. So for the rest of our practice for today, this is going to be the exercise. I'll mark the beginning and the end of this meditation with the bell. So just sit back and relax, practicing pure awareness. Place the palms of your hands in front of the heart center. Interlace your fingers. And now press your arms all the way forward, rounding your spine, bring your chin to your chest. And as you inhale, bring your arms all the way up, reach up to the sky, spread your fingers. And place the palms back in front of the chest. Thank you so much for joining today's practice. I'll see you tomorrow for day 20 out of 21. Namaste.